Paul Robeson, accompanied by Lawrence Brown.
Spirituals, then have some songs from other countries, and finally we have your requests. So now, with my good friend Lawrence Brown at the piano, we'll begin with a Negro spiritual. I've been in the storm so long. One of the great songs of the folk music of the world. One that became famous when Harry T. Burley, most distinguished American Negro composer, who was a friend of Dvorak, made an arrangement of it for solo voice and piano. That was back in 1917. And I think it would be true to say that it focused the attention of the whole world on Negro spirituals. Deep River, My Home is Over Jordan.
Deep River,
You might recall, of course, that in Negro life, these spirituals were born in struggle and were a part of the everyday life of our people. Something folk would talk about in ordinary conversation, day by day. And often we'd hear the elder folks explain, now you've got to live your religion. Live it. And the next song emphasizes that point. And not only that, but that if you have any gift, anything to share with your fellows, that you must do. So this one starts, this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine. Let it shine. Pointed out many times, among many of the peoples of the world, poetry, especially the folk heroic poetry, like of the bards of many folk, of the Celtic folk, the chanting in the various temples in the synagogue, the chanting of the Negro preacher in the church, points to the fact that the music and poetry are very close one to the other. And here is just a short excerpt from a poem by Paul Lawrence Dunbar, very distinguished poet of America. In a poem called When My Lindy Sings. I'm sort of starting about near the end of it, about how the beauty of the singing of My Lindy warms the hearts of all. What? You never heard My Lindy? Blessed soul, take up the cross. Look here. You're joking, honey. Well, you don't know what you lost. You ought to hear that girl a-warbling. Robins, larks, and all them sings hush their mouths and hide their faces when My Lindy sings. Fiddling man just stops his fiddling, lays his fiddle on the shelf. Mockingbird stops trying to whistle because he's just so shamed himself. Folks are playing on the banjo, drop their fingers on the strings. Bless your soul, forget to move them when My Lindy sings. Oh, it's sweeter than the music of an educated band. And it's dearer than the battle song of triumph in the land. It seems holier than evening when the solemn church bells ring. And I sit and calmly listen when My Lindy sings. Towser, stop that barking, hear me? Mandy, make that child keep still. Don't you hear the echoes calling from the valley to the hill? Let me listen, I can hear it. Through the burst of angels' wings, soft and sweet, swing low, sweet chariot, as My Lindy sings. And from another poet, just a short excerpt of this idea of the union of music and poetry, from The Passionate Pilgrim, Sonnet 6 of the immortal Shakespeare. If music and sweet poetry agree, as they must needs, the sister and the brother, then must the love be great twixt thee and me, because thou lovest the one, and I the other. The poet speaks of the joy and the comfort that music brings, and Handel expressed the same theme when he wrote, Art thou troubled? Art thou weary? Music will calm thee. Source of all gladness. we said earlier, I always like to sing the songs, the folk songs of different countries. And I've taken another from Scotland. And for my many good friends there, I'll sing a song about Vairihu, about Dark Mary, called Turn Ye to Me. Now comes a very beautiful song from Russia, from the Ukraine, one of the richest lands of music. It's called Night. And like most of the folk music, its appeal is universal. And this one, Night, is a song about autumn. Not a bleak time of the year. I'm one of my favorite sort of parts of the year somehow. And this song is calling on one's beloved in the autumn.
Not a single
have been many requests for a poem by William Blake, one of my favorite poets. And certainly were he alive, Blake would agree that souls have no color. Neither black, nor white, nor brown, nor yellow. No color. I'm beginning with the second stanza of The Little Black Boy, one of the songs of innocence by Blake. My mother taught me underneath a tree, and sitting down before the heat of day, she took me on her lap and kissed me, and pointing to the east began to say, look on the rising sun, there God does live, and gives his light and gives his heat away. And flowers and trees and beasts and men receive comfort in morning, joy in the noonday. And we are put on earth a little space, that we may learn to bear the beams of love. And these black bodies and this sunburnt face is but a cloud, and like a shady grove. For when our souls have learned the heat to bear, the cloud will vanish. We shall hear his voice saying, come out from the grove, my love and care, and round my golden tent like lambs rejoice. Thus did my mother say, and kissed me. And thus I say to little English boy, when I from black and he from white cloud free, and round the tent of God like lambs we joy, I'll shade him from the heat till he can bear to lean in joy upon our father's knee. And then I'll stand and stroke his silver hair and be like him, and he will then love me. And now a beautiful lullaby from one of my films, My Little Black Dove. asleep at my breast, my little black dove. My little black dove. The last was a request that's come from many sources. And another one, which I haven't sung in quite a long while, a very humorous one, called Shortnin Bread. Put on the skillet, put on the lid, Mama's gonna bake a little shortnin bread. That ain't all she's gonna do, Mama's gonna make a little coffee too. Three little children lying in bed, two was sick and the other most dead. Sent for the doctor said, feed those children on shortening bread. Mama's little baby loves shortening, shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening bread. Mama's little baby loves shortening, shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening bread. Slip up the lid, slip my pockets full of shortening bread. Stole the skillet, stole the lid, stole the gal to make shortening bread. Mama's little baby loves shortening, shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening bread. Mama's little baby loves shortening, shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening bread. They caught me with a skillet, caught me with a lid, caught me with the gal making shortening bread. Paid $6 for the skillet, paid $6 for the lid, spent 6 months in jail on shortening bread. Mama's little baby loves shortening, shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening bread. Mama's little baby loves shortening, shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening. And welcome to another quiet little session of music and memories. Often in traveling about on the trains or in the streets, happy memories are brought back to me by people who stop me, friends, and tell me about the songs that they heard me sing way back in the 20s, when I came in Drury Lane in Sherwood in 1928 and in the 30s. And often they tell me that they were children at the time. And now they have children of their own and they all sort of like some of my songs. Makes me feel slightly along in years, but also like one of the family. So it's good now with my friend Larry Brown at the piano to sing a Negro spiritual, which I like very much, On My Journey Now, Mount Zion. So here we are, On My Journey Now.
On my journey now, Mount Zion, my journey now, Mount Zion. I wouldn't take another in a Mount Zion. On my journey, Mount Zion. One day, I was walking along. Well, the elements opened, and the love come down, Mount Zion. On my journey now, Mount Zion, my journey now, Mount Zion. I wouldn't take another in a Mount Zion. On my journey now, about me, just couldn't take enough in a Mount Zion for my journey now. Mount Zion.
Again, that's an example of a spiritual which a Negro congregation may be in days long past, built around an idea which they learned in church. For my people who created these songs, they took the Bible very seriously, because in the days of servitude, this was the only book they were allowed to read. And in the church service, the preacher would build his sermon around a particular text from the Bible. And often he would give the sort of one line, and then the congregation would join in, sort of preacher and chorus. Before one knew it, there was another beautiful spiritual born. And so when he sings, "Oh, what a beautiful city," the Negro is speaking about the heavenly city, which he read about in the Bible, the heavenly city of Jerusalem and its 12 gates. And the wall of the city had 12 foundations, and in them the names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. As I often play Shakespeare these days, I think of the great joy that my ancestors found in a language very similar, the language of the King James Version of the Bible. Oh, what a beautiful city.
Oh, what a beautiful city. Oh, what a beautiful city. Oh, what a beautiful city. 12 gates are to the city. Hallelujah. Oh, what a beautiful city. Oh, what a beautiful city. Beautiful city, 12 gates to the city, hallelujah. 3 gates in the east, 3 gates in the west, 3 gates in the north, 3 gates in the south, making it 12 gates to the city, hallelujah. Oh, what a beautiful city. Oh, what a beautiful city. 12 gates to the city. Hallelujah. My Lord built that city, and he said it was just 4 square. And he said he wanted you sinners to meet him in the air. To the city, hallelujah. Oh, what a beautiful city. Oh, what a beautiful city. Oh, what a beautiful city. 12 gates, 12 gates.
I think it was William Watson who said that little masters make a toy of song till grave men weary of the sound of rhyme. Well, at home, they are really pretty difficult sometimes. My little masters happen to be my own grandchildren. In fact, they happen to have been over with me sometime this summer. I miss them a great deal. But when I'm with them, I don't get all tired out. I have to stay with them. And they like me to sing to them, and I do my best, but they always come up, I guess from looking, maybe at TV, I don't know. They say, "What about some cowboy songs?" So I've had to learn one or two of them. But I found that if I come through with something that has a lilt, A little smack of adventure, like roaming around the world. They seem to like it just as well. And it could be one like this that we all know. About a great river, the Rio Grande.
Song of the fish of the sea, oh Rio, I'll sing you a song of the fish of the sea, and we're bound for the Rio Grande. Then away, love, away, down Rio, so fare ye well, my pretty young girl.
Singing too long. So I watch the clock pretty carefully. And when it's about time, really time's up, really time to go to sleep, then I start on a lullaby, which they know is good night. They have many favorites. One they like very much is the next one, the Castle of Dromore.
By Lula, Lula. sing hush a by low. Take time to thrive, my rose of hope in the garden of Dromore. Take heed, young eagle, till your wings have feathers fit to soar. A little rest and then the world is full of work to do. Sing hush-a-bye, lullaby, sing hush-a-bye.
A great composer, not only of yours, but of all the world, was the late Dr. Vaughan Williams. And recently, when I played his record of Greensleeves, relating it to his Fantasia on a theme by Tallis, I said I'd like to sing it to you myself sometime. Now, whether or not King Henry VIII wrote this song, I don't know, but if he did, he certainly had a hit on his hands. What is clear is that it is mentioned by Shakespeare in The Merry Wives of Windsor, and certainly this is a beautiful melody of the English countryside, Greensleeves.
Alas, my love, you do me wrong to cast me off disgrace. And I have loved you so long, delighting in your company. Greensleeves was all my joy, Greensleeves was my delight. Greensleeves was my heart of gold, and but my Lady Greensleeves. Thou couldst desire no earthly thing, but still thou hadst it readily. Thy music still all my joy, Greensleeves was my delight. Greensleeves was my heart of gold, and who but my Lady Greensleeves.
Each week, I'd like to give you some of the songs which you ask for, and And here's one which a great many of you seem to like very much. We in Negro America have had many distinguished poets. One, Paul Lawrence Dunbar, whom we like to think of as our Robert Burns, which is certainly a great tribute, because there was no greater poet than Burns, of course. My friend Larry Brown played this tune about 50 years ago, he says. He's not a young fellow, you know. But still carries on very well. And years ago in Harlem, when I used to sing it, New York, my wife, Islanda, who is with me here, says that every girl I happened to look at thought I was singing it just for her. Well, maybe that's the way it should be with a song like Little Gal. Earlier in the program, I spoke about Negro spirituals stemming from the Bible stories. Well, here is one of the best-known Bible stories, that of Joshua at the Battle of Jericho. So the people shouted when the priests blew with the trumpets, and it came to pass when the people heard the sound of the trumpet, and the people shouted with a great shout, that the wall fell down flat, so that the people went up into the city, every man straight before him, and they took the city. Here in this Joshua at the Battle of Jericho, sung by Mr. Brown and myself, you will hear one of the finest arrangements of our Negro music by Lawrence Brown. Note the rhythm, it goes back to our African heritage, one of the finest of our folk songs.
The Battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. is the battle of Jericho, and the walls come tumbling down that morning. Gossip is the battle of Jericho, Jericho.
You may talk about the king of Gideon, you may talk about the man of Saul. There's none like good old Joshua
at the battle of Jericho.
Up to the walls of Jericho, he marched with spear in hand. Go below them, Ram Mahona, Joshua cried,
hold the battle lamb in my hand.
Then the lamb ram people begin to blow, trumpet begin to sound. Joshua commanded the children to shout,
and the walls come a-tumbling down.
That morning,
Joshua fit the battle of Jericho,
oh,
Jericho,
yes,
Jericho. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, and the walls come a-tumbling down.
That morning,
Joshua fit the battle of Jericho,
oh,
Jericho,
yes,
Jericho. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho,
and the walls.